It's back to basics in Tuesday's fourth installment of the oral arguments on petitions challenging the Anti-Terrorism Act. A simple question coming from Associate Justice Rodil Zalameda.
Is there really a need right now for the Philippines to have an anti-terror law?
The Human Security Act is enough, Your Honor. Deter terrorism. What is really lacking is good police work and good intelligence work.
The Human Security Act is the law which the Anti-Terrorism Act replaced. Petitioners say there was no need to replace it in the first place, as it in fact offered more safeguards. But magistrates point out the need to give authorities sufficient leeway to address the evolving threats of terrorism, even if it means penalizing preparatory acts. Justice Mario Lopez says terrorism is even worse than treason and rebellion. Justice Amy Lazaro Javier, for her part, asks if individual rights should be prioritized over the security of the country and its people. But petitioners insist there's a need to balance the duty of the state to prevent terrorism and the Bill of Rights of every individual, which are enshrined in the Constitution.
Their argument, Your Honor, that we need the ATL because we don't have the tools to ferret out these crimes is actually wrong, Your Honor.
In fighting a fire like terrorism, we do not throw the baby out with the bathwater. We preserve our constitutional order by being different from terrorists. And because we don't, we end up making them win. We are no different from the lawless elements that we are fighting.
The oral arguments got heated when Justice Mario Lopez and Professor John Molo discussed whether the Supreme Court could entertain a facial challenge on the ground of void for vagueness in a penal law concerning national security. Lopez says it has never been done before, which Molo counters by pointing to several cases where the Supreme Court looked into the constitutionality of a penal law which infringed freedom of speech and fundamental rights, even if no person has claimed to have suffered actual and direct injury.
Yes, Your Honor.
The exchange ended cordially.
14 of 15 Supreme Court magistrates took turns interpolating petitioners in the past four Tuesdays on whether or not to scrap the anti-terror law. It's now the turn of the Solicitor General to make its case on why the Philippines needs a new anti-terror measure. Mike Navallo, ABS-CBN News.